Hi everyone, so in this video we will talk about setup and installation, which is pretty much straightforward. What you need to do, you need to go to the Docker desktop, this particular link which is given in the bottom, Docker desktop, and you just need to install DMG because I'm on the Mac, so you just need to do the installation using DMG file like any other application we install on Docker. Then on top, you will be able to see this Docker running. Right now, it is not running, so let me spin that up. So now Docker is running, right? And you will be able to see something like this. Okay, it's taking time. So you will see this kind of the box as a drop down where you can start, restart. These kind of options, you are seeing that, right? About Docker, Kubernetes, quit Docker, restart, documentation, kitematic, all these options you will be able to see. So right now my Docker is up and running. Docker is starting, right? So it will take some time, then we will be able to run the few commands. So Docker is already installed on my system, but when you will be installing it for first time, you can just check all these things. You can just check the preferences of a Docker. So this is the preference box. In the preferences, what we are saying, the file sharing, disk, advance, the proxies, daemon process, the Kubernetes, which is right now, it's not there. Okay, so I'm not applying any changes for now. Okay, so this is how our Docker is up and running. So what we can do, let's run a few commands. So Docker versioning, Docker is installed, then it will give you this information. Then Docker images, these are the few basic commands which we will talk in the details later, like all the list of all the images which I have, which I'm having right now. Let me just okay, Docker images, Docker ps-a, it will give you active running containers in the Docker. Docker info, I think that is the command. So these are the different commands you can see. The config, containers, images, you can remove the images, you can add a new image, you can build the containers, you can remove the containers. So container is nothing but container is an instance of an image. We will talk about all these things in depth. Okay, so these are all different options we can run. Okay, so you just need to pass Docker and your command name, like start, stop, Docker RMI. Here you can pass your image name. What it will do, it will actually remove the image from the Docker. Let's try to run the Docker run hello world. So what it will do, it will try to look at hello world image. So I will explain this. What it is doing, it is trying to run the hello world image. Okay, Docker and hello world, but hello world latest is not available locally. So first it will download it, latest, pulling this hello world image. Okay, then it is running that image. Okay, so Docker run, if you see Docker ps-a, this hello world is actually a container which has been created and exited because we didn't do anything. We just run that container, we didn't execute anything. So Docker, if you wanted to go inside it, because it's, first of all, it's not up and running container. So what we did is a hello world, and you can also pass the command. So okay, first of all, it's not a container. So Docker ps-a is giving you all the list of containers. Hello world is actually the container we created by pulling the image from Docker Hub, and we started it. So it is Docker run is actually short command to pull the image from Docker Hub and run it. Forget about all these things, because currently we are on the step one. First we need to understand the image, first we need to understand the container, how we are building it, what all the different commands and all. These are just the basic idea about the different commands which you will be running. Docker RMI, Docker ps-a, which will give you all the active running containers. Docker ps will give you all the active running containers. Docker ps-a will give you all the active and exited containers. Okay, Docker images will give you all the list of images which we have in the application. Docker, there are a lot of other images. Docker build. If you wanted to pass some Docker file, then this will be the command for it. Okay. So let's continue. Docker overview will talk about. So these are the three different building blocks: Docker image, Docker build, Docker container, and Docker compose. These are actually running in sequence. There is a Docker image. We will build it. We will create a container. That's it. So this is actually the flow. Then we will use a Docker ps minus Docker compose. Okay, let's talk about few basic commands. Docker ps minus a give you all the list of containers. Docker images give you all the list of Docker images we have downloaded or we have them locally. Docker architecture, in the next video, first we will talk about Docker architecture. We will try to combine all these terms. There is a Docker image, there is a Docker container, Docker build is happening, which is creating the container from the image. Then there is some image we are pulling from somewhere, right? So we will try to connect all the dots in the Docker architecture.